Les verbes du troisième groupe, and we'll see more precisely in this video how to conjugate the verbs that are ending with this I-R-E thing. So, ir, okay, and we'll see that basically they are quite tricky to conjugate. Okay, so let's start right now. And I thought that it would be more logical to put them, sorry, in two groups. And the first one is actually and logically IRE, and the second one, we are talking about the verbs that will end with OIRE, WAR, or then AIRE, ER. Alright? My advice for this video is actually to probably make a list on your own and try to learn them by heart, because it will be the only way to actually remember them. Okay? But then let's start with the first group, IRE. So the first verb that we'll see is lire, and lire means to read, okay? So, je lis, tu lis, il lit, elle lit, nous lisons, vous lisez, ils lisent, elles lisent. Alright, so, je lis, tu lis, il lit, okay, so, same form here, phonetical form, but then it's S at the end, S and then T. Then you will get nous lisons, vous lisez, ils lisent. Okay, so this one honestly is not that tricky, so that's the reason why I wanted to start with this one. Let's see now the second one. And it's dire, and dire means to say. Je dis, tu dis, il dit, elle dit. Nous disons, vous dites, and now you can see the tricky thing here. So it's not vous disiez, okay, as many would think, but then it's vous dites, okay, final S not pronounced, vous dites. Ils disent, elles disent. Alright, so let's see that one more time. Je dis, tu dis, il dit, elle dit. So basically here it's not that difficult, because I'm pretty sure that most of you would actually, without knowing that, try to conjugate it and put these forms. Okay, so je dis, tu dis, il dit, elle dit. Then nous disons. So far it's actually quite logical, but this is the tricky thing here. Vous dites. Okay, so remember that, well, in most of the cases at the beginning, you will say vous disiez, okay, and it's quite interesting because French kids normally, when they start to learn the language, they don't use this vous dites, but then they make this logical mistake, vous disiez, okay, but it's actually vous dites, and then ils, elles disent. Third verb is écrire. Écrire is to write. And then, j'écris, tu écris, il écrit, elle écrit. Same thing here. It's really easy, okay? It's getting normally tricky at the plural form. Nous écrivons, and this is the strange thing here. You've got to put this V here. Écrivons, okay? But then you keep the logic, in a way, vous écrivez, okay, so V is coming here as well, and it will be here for the plural form as well, okay, ils écrivent, elles écrivent. Alright, so, j'écris, tu écris, il écrit, elle écrit, nous écrivons, vous écrivez, ils écrivent, elles écrivent. So keep in mind that for écrire, actually, the tricky thing will be to put this V for the plural form. Rire. And it's to laugh. Je ris. Tu ris. Il rit. Elle rit. Nous rions. And this is a tricky thing, nothing between I and O. Rions, vous riez, il rit, elle rit. And keep in mind that here, at the end, Okay, you've got this ENT, but if you remember, because I've been talking about that quite many times, you don't pronounce this final ENT. And so phonetically, you get the sound RI. Okay, exactly like you have here. RI, 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 RI. Okay, so and then here, RION, RIER. Okay, so you get je ris, tu ris, il rit, elle rit, nous rions, vous riez, il rit, elle rit. So now comes the second subgroup. Okay, we're talking about the verbs ending with voir or air. And so for the first verb, I decided to take plaire, and plaire is to please. Je plais, tu plais, il plaît, elle plaît. Have a look here. Accent circonflexe for il and elle, but not for tu and not for je. Okay. Nous plaisons, vous plaisez, il plaise, elle plaise. And that's normally the tricky thing, because in many situations, persons or students will put air here because they are logic, and in a way French language can be quite strange. So basically you will have to put S here, but then the good news is that it's coming also for vous and then for il, elle. Okay, so this is the tricky thing here. But then je plais, tu plais, il plaît, elle plaît. Well, this circonflexe also. Nous plaisons, vous plaisez, il plaise, elle plaise. Faire is quite useful, and we use this verb quite often in French because it means to do. Okay, so let's see how we will conjugate it. Je fais, tu fais, il fait, elle fait. Nous faisons, vous faites, ils font, elles font. Okay, so this one is a tricky one. Well, basically, if you think about je, tu, il and elle, well, this is not really tricky, and this is quite easy to make because phonetically it's fait, fait, fait. And then for the endings, it's quite logical, S, S, T. Like we have normally for the third group, okay? Now, nous is actually quite strange, because even if, of course, you put this S here, and in a way it's a surprise, but then the most difficult thing that you should keep in mind is the way you will pronounce it, because you don't pronounce it E, as normally you should, but you will pronounce it like E. Nous faisons. Okay, it's really f, f, f. Nous faisons. Okay, you see it with e, but then you pronounce it f. Nous faisons. So this is the first difficulty. And the second one is here, because if you look, it's a bit like we had for dire previously. Actually, you don't have this faisait. If you would be logical, it would go like that. But then it's fait. Okay, so keep in mind these two things are actually quite tricky. The first one here for pronunciation, nous faisons, and the second one here because you write it like that and it's not vous faisez but vous faites. Okay, and then ils font, elles font. So just for one more time, je fais, tu fais, il fait, elle fait. Nous faisons, vous faites. Ils font, elles font. Okay? This one is important because we use it quite often in French. We've got many expressions that are combined or constructed with faire. Okay, so keep in mind that it goes like that. Faisons and then faites. Mm-hmm. Croire. Croire is to believe, and it's quite useful as well. So, je crois. Tu crois, il croit, elle croit, And now you've got this Y here, and the sound goes like nous croyons, okay? Croyons. Vous croyez. And last but not least, look, il croit, elle croit. And phonetically here, as we saw, ent is not pronounced, so you get the sound croit. Exactly the same sound as we've got here. Croit, croit, and then croit. Okay, so one more time. Je crois, tu crois, il croit, elle croit, nous croyons, vous croyez, il croit, elle croit. Okay, so keep in mind that here, when you get this Y and two vowels, one before, one after, it will be like yeah. So you combine it with O first, you will get croyons. Croyons. And here, croyez, croyez. Okay? Boire, and boire is to drink, so it's quite useful. You do that every day, or then at least you should. Je bois, tu bois, il boit, elle boit. And this is the tricky one. Nous buvons. Vous buvez, ils boivent, elles boivent. Okay, so same thing here. If you look carefully, you've got, well, three different stems. So, bois here, so it will be actually quite easy at the singular. So, je bois, tu bois, il boit. Okay, then for nous and vous, you've got this stem, so B-U-V, then you put the ending. Buvons, then buvez. And for il, elle, we've got a third stem or root, and it's B-O-I-V, and you put the ending, E-N-T. Okay, so you get je bois, tu bois, il boit, elle boit, nous buvons, vous buvez, ils boivent, elles boivent. Les verbes du troisième groupe, and more precisely, we'll see together how to conjugate the verbs that are ending with dre and indre at the present form, because they can be quite tricky. Okay, so let's start. So the first group, I thought it might be interesting to take a quite common verb, attendre. And attendre means to wait, okay, so attendre. And for the second group, so the indre group, we'll see the verb craindre. Craindre is to fear. Okay, so attendre and then craindre. Okay, but then let's start with attendre. So basically, you've got your ending dre. Okay, so the verb is attendre. And the thing that you've got to keep in mind is that in that case, you will take re away. Okay, so you will get j'attends. And then for tu, it will be tu attends. For il, elle, il attend. For nous, nous attendons. Vous attendez. Ils attendent, elles attendent. Okay, so if you look carefully, basically you can see that the infinitive form is attendre. Okay, and as I told you, then you take this re away. Okay, so you will get this form, A-T-T-E-N-D. And after that, you will basically add the endings. So for je, it will be S, okay? And that's the reason why you've got this attend, like that. So D, and then you just add this S. For tu, it will be also S, okay? Same form. Then for il, elle, don't put anything, okay? So that's the reason why you've got the basic form. Then for nous, the classic ending, O-N-S, okay? For vous, you will have E-Z, okay? So that's the reason why you get this attendez form. And for il, elle, you will get E-N-T. Okay, so that's the way that, well, these verbs ending with dre will be conjugated, okay? So you get j'attends, tu attends, il attend, elle attend, nous attendons, vous attendez, ils attendent, elles attendent. All right? And, well, if you think about the verb attendre in that case, let's see the verbs that will be conjugated like attendre. Okay, so répondre, for instance, confondre, descendre, défendre, entendre, perdre, prétendre, rendre, répandre, tendre, vendre, and other verbs as well. Okay, but I cannot make the full list. Okay, so these verbs will be conjugated like attendre. Okay, but then I'm pretty sure that you are expecting some translations here. Okay, so that's the reason why they are coming now. So répondre, it's to answer. Okay, confondre, to get mixed up, descendre, to go down, défendre, defend, entendre, to hear, perdre, to lose, prétendre, to claim, rendre, to give back, répandre, to spread, tendre, to stretch, and then vendre, to sell. Okay, so these verbs will actually be conjugated just like attendre was conjugated a few minutes ago. Okay, so répondre, confondre, descendre, défendre, entendre, perdre, prétendre, rendre, répandre, tendre, and then vendre. Okay, but as you know, like almost all the time in French, we've got some exceptions. Okay, and of course, the verb prendre, and it's quite used because it means to take, is an exception. Okay, so even if it's ending with DRE, well, basically, it won't behave like attendre that we saw previously. Okay, so let's see how it goes. So, DRE, prendre, you've got to remember that the forms will go like that. Je prends, tu prends, il, elle prend, nous prenons, and here you can see the difference. Vous prenez, and the last one is quite tricky because it's il, elle prennent. Okay, so basically you double the N here, and it will give you different sound here because you get to open the sound, so it's prêt, prenne. Okay, so let's see that one more time. Je prends, tu prends, il prend, elle prend. So if we look carefully, actually we get, I mean, these forms are pronounced the same, okay? Then we've got nous prenons. Okay, keep in mind that you should pronounce it prenons, vous prenez, and then the last one, the tricky one, ils prennent. Okay, ils prennent. All right. So basically, remember that prenons, prenez, and then prennent will be different as the forms that we had for attendre, for instance. Okay, and when we speak about prendre, actually we've got the verbs apprendre, comprendre, entreprendre, reprendre, surprendre, and a few others. And these verbs will actually be conjugated as prendre. Alright, so let's see what they mean. Apprendre means to learn. Comprendre, understand. Entreprendre, begin doing something. Reprendre, to take again or to take back. And then surprendre, surprise. Okay, so keep in mind that these verbs will actually be conjugated like prendre. All right, and so now let's see the second main category that we had, and it's indre. And the verb, the example that we will take is craindre, and craindre means to fear. Je crains, tu crains, il craint, elle craint, nous craignons, vous craignez, ils craignent, elles craignent. Okay, so you can see that for nous, vous, and then il, elle at the plural form, it is quite tricky because you've got this GN coming right here, and then the sound is craignons. Okay, you get the gn sound. Okay, craignons, craignez, craignent. Okay, but then if you remember to put it here, So the good news, they say, is that it will come for nous, it will come for vous, and then it will come for il, elle, at the plural form. So je crains, tu crains, il craint, elle craint, nous craignons, vous craignez, ils craignent, elles craignent. Alright, so keep in mind that ending will be S, S, and then T, okay, but then phonetically, as you know, you pronounce them the same. Crin, 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 okay? Then O, N, S, craignons, craignez, E, Z, and then craigne, E, N, T. And of course, we'll see few verbs that will be conjugated like craindre, and they are atteindre, contraindre, éteindre, joindre, peindre, plaindre, teindre, and few others. Okay, so atteindre, contraindre, éteindre, joindre, peindre, plaindre, teindre. And so let's see what they mean. Atteindre, it's to reach. Contraindre, force, constrain. Éteindre, turn off. Joindre, join, combine. Peindre, paint. Plaindre, pity, complain. And then teindre, die. Okay, and so keep in mind that these verbs will be actually conjugated the same way as craindre is conjugated. Alright? Les verbes du troisième groupe, and more precisely, we'll see together how to conjugate at the present form the verbs that will end with T-R-E, tre. Okay, so we can start right now. And I thought it might be more logical or easier to divide them in two groups. Okay, the first one would be verbs ending with T-R-E, so it's not a big surprise. But the second one, and I thought that maybe we should put them in a special group. So the verbs ending with être and oître. Okay, so A-I, accent circonflexe, T-R-E, être. Oître, O-I, accent circonflexe, T-R-E. Okay, so, because basically they will behave a bit differently. So, let's start now with the first one, so the verbs ending with T-R-E. And for this group, I thought it might be interesting to use a quite useful verb, mettre. Mettre is to put. Okay, and so the concept is that you will have for the singular form, one stem or one root, okay, and it will be M-E-T. And for the plural, you will have actually another stem, another root, and it will be M-E-T-T-T. And this is the tricky thing if we're talking about these verbs, okay? So let's see how it will go. So, je mets. So you can see that now, as we saw, you put back this M-E-T, so the root, M-E-T, and then you add here the ending, S. Tu mets, il met, elle met. Okay? So then now, if we think about that, we should, for the plural form, put back this M-E-T-T, and after that we will put the ending. And this is the reason why we'll get nous mettons. So you can see that we put back M-E-T-T, and then the ending O-N-S. Nous mettons. Then, vous mettez, so in the same way, we keep this first part, so the root or the stem, plus the ending. And then finally, il met, elle met, exactly the same thing. And this is basically the difficult thing when we're talking about this group of verbs, okay? Just to remember that for the singular form, you will have to use this stem here, and then for the plural, you will have to use another stem. Then, the endings will be S for je, So you will get je mets, s for tu mets, nothing for il, elle, so that's the reason why we have this met. Keep in mind that phonetically you pronounce them the same here. Mais, mais, mais. Okay? Then for nous, you will put the ending ons, but then keep in mind that the stem is different, m-e-t-t. For vous, e-zen, same thing, same stem here, and then e-n-t for il and elle. Okay, so now let's see few verbs that will be conjugated like mettre, and we're talking about admettre, commettre, compromettre, permettre, soumettre, transmettre, battre, abattre, combattre, débattre, and few others. Admettre, and it means admit, confess. Commettre, commit. Compromettre, compromise. Sorry, this is my French pronunciation here. Compromise would be more appropriate. Then permettre, allow, permit. Soumettre, submit, subdue. Transmettre, pass, transmit. Battre, beat, defeat. Abattre, knock down. Combattre, combat, fight. And then débattre, discuss, debate. I say, okay, so keep in mind that these verbs here will be actually conjugated the same way as mettre. So as we saw, we've got a second group here in this video, and it's actually concerning the verbs ending with être and ouatre. And for this group, I thought it might be interesting to have this verb connaître. Connaître is to know, okay, and we use that quite often, okay? And basically, we will have the same kind of situation, meaning for the singular form, we'll have one stem, one root, and it will be connaît, like that. And for the plural form, we will have a different stem or root, so connaisse. Okay, so connaît and then connaisse. And that's the reason why we'll get the following forms. Je connais, tu connais, il connaît, elle connaît. And keep in mind that it's a strange thing, I know, but you should put here this accent circumflexe. You don't pronounce it, I know that, but then if you want to write correctly, you should put it here, okay? It doesn't come for je, it doesn't come for tu, but then it will come here for il and elle. It's strange, I know, but still that's the way it should be done. For the plural form, keep in mind that we've got our stem here, our root connaisse, okay? So we should put it back here and then add the ending ons. Nous connaissons, vous connaissez, ils connaissent, elles connaissent. Alright, so one more time, you just put for the singular this stem here, and then for je you will add s, for tu you will add s, for il you will add t. And that's the reason why you will get je connais, tu connais, il connaît, elle connaît. And then keep in mind this little circumflex thing here. But then for the plural form, we've got a different stem, connaisse, and then the endings will be the same, ons as usual, ez and ent, so you will get the forms nous connaissons, vous connaissez, ils connaissent, elles connaissent. Alright? So it's actually a bit difficult probably at the beginning, but once you have the idea that actually you've got two different stems for the singular and for the plural, then it's actually quite easy. Regarding the circumflex thing, well, it's up to you if you want to write it or not, but you should put it, of course. Let's see now together the verbs that will actually be conjugated like connaître. And they are accroître, croître, paraître, apparaître, disparaître, naître, renaître, reconnaître, comparaître, and few others. So regarding the translation now, accroître needs to increase. Croître, grow. Paraître, appear, seem. Apparaître, come into being. Disparaître, disappear. Naître, be born. Renaître, rise, be reborn. Reconnaître, recognize. Comparaître, appear before. Okay, and these verbs will actually be conjugated like connaître. Le futur proche, so basically if you want to translate it directly, it would be the near future. So what is le futur proche exactly? It's the possibility that we have in French and in other languages to construct basically a future with aller at the present form, followed by the infinitive, so the basic form of the verb. Okay, so like in English you would say I am going to travel, for instance. In French we would say je vais voyager. Okay, so remember first aller that you conjugate at the present form, and then you will put your verb at the infinitive form. Okay, so first of course we did introduce the verb aller and the way to conjugate it, but still I think that it is really important to see how it goes. So we will see one more time the conjugation of aller at the present form. Okay, first person here, je vais. Remember, final S not pronounced. Je vais. Okay, tu vas. Same thing here, final S not pronounced. Tu vas. Il, elle va. Nous allons. Final S not pronounced. And then when you get this ON combination, you get this nasal on, really in your nose, okay? On. And then let's make this little liaison here to make it sound more beautiful. Nous allons. Nous allons. Okay? Same thing here. Vous allez. Vous allez. Alright? Remember, classic ending for vous, a Z, okay? But then when you combine these two letters, you get the sound E. Okay? Allez. And then vous allez. Alright? And the last persons. Ils, elles vont. Ils vont. Elles vont. Okay, remember, final T not pronounced, so you get this ON nasal here. On vont. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Je vais. Tu vas. Il va. Elle va. Nous allons. Vous allez. Ils vont. Elles vont. Okay, so that's the first part that we will use to construct this futur proche, okay? And then the second part will be, well, the verb that you want to express, but at the infinitive form. So I've been writing few examples here. So the first sentence, je vais voyager. Voyager means to travel. Avec, with, ma famille, my family. Je vais voyager avec ma famille. Okay? So, quite simple way to construct a future form. Tu vas chercher. Chercher means to search. Une nouvelle maison. Okay? Une nouvelle. Nouvelle, it's the feminine form of the adjective nouveau, new. Okay, because maison, house, as you can see here, is feminine. So, une nouvelle maison, a new house. Tu vas chercher une nouvelle maison. Okay? And then, il, elle va partir. Partir is to leave. Okay? Pour means for. Pour un an. One year. Un an. Okay? So I will make the liaison just to make it more normal after. Okay, but I just want to divide here. Un an. Okay? So let's read it normally now. Il va partir pour un an. Okay? So you can hear that now I make this link between the two. Un an. Un an. So no break between the two. Un an. Okay? Il va partir pour un an. Elle va partir pour un an. Okay? Then for nous. Nous allons chanter. Chanter means to sing. Okay? Cette chanson. So remember, cette feminine form of ce, this. Okay? Chanson, song. And as chanson is feminine, so you should put this form here at the feminine. This. Okay? Nous allons chanter cette chanson. Nous allons chanter cette chanson. And then for vous, vous allez adorer. So adorer, to adore, to love a lot. Ce film. Okay? Ce, so you see now this. Okay? But then it's the masculine form because film, film here is masculine. Ce film, this movie. Okay? Vous allez adorer ce film. Vous allez adorer ce film. And the last one. Ils vont boire, boire is to drink, un café, a coffee. Ils vont boire un café. Elles vont boire un café. Okay, so let's repeat everything again. Je vais voyager avec ma famille. Tu vas chercher une nouvelle maison. Il va partir pour un an. Elle va partir pour un an. Nous allons chanter cette chanson. Vous allez adorer ce film. Ils vont boire un café. Elles vont boire un café. Bonjour à tous, hi everyone and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 4, leçon B. And in this lesson, sorry, we'll try to work on le genre des mots, so the gender of the words, because normally that's something a bit difficult for students to know or to remember the gender of the words. So normally what I tell them is to try to memorize, try to remember the gender when they discover or when they see a new word, but I know it's not easy. Okay, so in this lesson we'll try to see actually a few endings that give you some useful tips, and well, we'll focus only on the feminine words, and we'll start right now. Sorry. So when you see words that are ending with this ion, so you can be almost. This is quite important. Never say always when you talk about French language, because you always find some exceptions. Okay, so I won't say always. I will say in most of the cases. Okay, when they end with ion. Okay, they in most of the cases they will be feminine. Okay, so for instance here, la libération, or then la nation. Okay. Other ending is t, so when a word is finishing or ending with t like that, la rapidité. Rapidité means speed. And then la santé, health. Okay, in this case you can be almost sure that these words will be feminine. Okay, when they're ending with ure, ur. Okay, la peinture, paint, la voiture, car. Okay, so they are feminine. And then when they're ending with s like that, e, s, s, e. So for instance, la politesse, La vitesse. Vitesse means speed. Okay? So these words are feminine and these endings are classical ending for feminine form. Okay, so let's see them one more time. La libération, la nation, la rapidité, la santé, la peinture, la voiture, la politesse, la vitesse. Okay, so let's see a few more. So, still for the feminine form. So, when you will have a word ending with this e, double t, e, et, okay, for instance, la chaussette, la roulette, so they will be feminine, okay, chaussette means sock, and then roulette, well, it's the same, the thing you will find in casinos. And then, when they're ending with ie, like here, okay, so basically you don't pronounce the e, okay, so it will be only the sound i, okay, for instance, la vie, life, okay, la partie, the part, okay, so they will be feminine as well, okay, and then words ending with e, accent aigu, and then e here, okay, remember this final e is not pronounced, so you will have this e, remember, accent aigu, it's e. Sound, okay. La poupée, the doll. L'arrivée, the arrival, okay. La poupée, l'arrivée. So feminine as well. In that case, remember that normally it should be la arrivée, but as arrivée, as usual, you know, start with a vowel, then a is disappearing, and then you just put this apostrophe, okay. And then words ending with ude, like that, ude. Ud, okay, are normally, in most of the cases, feminine. La gratitude. Well, if I, my understanding is correct, it's exactly the same in English. La gratitude. And then same thing here. Latitude. Latitude. Okay, so let's repeat them one more time. La chaussette. La roulette. La vie. La partie. La poupée, l'arrivée, la gratitude, l'attitude. Okay, I know it's not the key. It's not the magic key that will help you forever and that will give you all the time the correct gender of the words, but still you've got some tips now. Okay, it was leçon B. Okay, remember that I've been doing many lessons, so they can be found there on youtube.com/imagier, okay, and then the website is here, imagier.net. You can find more material there. Have a nice day, bye bye. L'article partitif. So what's l'article partitif? Well, basically it's when you want to say that you want some sugar, for instance, so you don't want to specify the quantity. Okay, just want to say that you want some, but you don't want to say one, two, three. Okay, then as usual, we will have the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form. Okay, so for the masculine form, it will be du. Okay, du. Simple thing, de, u. This is u, this is de, du. All right. And then for the feminine form, it will be de la. Okay? De la. All right? Masculine form, du. Feminine form, de la. All right? Let's see a few examples now. Je bois. Boire is to drink. Okay? So, je bois du café. All right? So, you can see the difference here. It would be possible to say je bois un café. Okay? In that case, you would translate it je bois un café by I drink one coffee or I drink a coffee. Okay? In that case, when you put this du café, so first you put the masculine form because café is masculine. Okay? And then you want to say, you don't want to specify the quantity, you want to say I drink some coffee. Okay? Je bois du café. Okay? The other option as well would be to say je bois le café. So if you want to put this article défini, but then you would have to put more information after le café de ma mère, the coffee of my mother, if you want. Okay? So in that case, in this lesson, we'll only focus on l'article partitif. So it's some. Okay? Je bois du café. All right? Let's see another option. Tu voudrais. So I wanted to introduce this voudrais form. Okay? So it's coming from vouloir. Vouloir is to want. Okay? But then it's not the present form here. The classic present form, it's the conditionnel form, okay? So it's the polite form that normally we should use. So I would like to have, you know, you don't say tu veux, you don't say you want, because it is too strong and too direct. So normally we tend to use this conditionnel form. So tu voudrais, you would like to have. And then salade, okay, and it's feminine, so you should put the feminine form of this partitif, so de la salade, so some salad, okay. Tu voudrais de la salade, all right. Let's see another example here. Nous mangeons, so manger is to eat, okay, and that's the form for nous, okay. Nous mangeons du gâteau. Gâteau is cake, okay? And it's masculine, so du gâteau. We eat some cake. Vous voulez, okay, so vouloir again, all right, to want, okay, but here it's the present form, okay? Do you want? Vous voulez du fromage, cheese, du fromage, so some cheese. And it's a question. Vous voulez du fromage? Okay. And the last example here. So I've been putting this il y a. We'll see that a bit later in this unit, but it will come. Il y a means there is. Okay. Il y a, there is. Okay. Il y a de la neige. Neige is snow. Okay. Par terre, on the ground. Par terre. So there is snow on the ground. Il y a de la neige par terre. Okay, so let's repeat all these sentences. The first one, je bois du café. Second one, tu voudrais de la salade. Nous mangeons du gâteau. Vous voulez du fromage? It's a question, so I've been insisting a little bit too much maybe. Let's do it one more time. Vous voulez du fromage? And the last one, il y a de la neige par terre. Pourquoi? Why? Pourquoi? Why? Okay? So, if you ask a question with pourquoi? Why? Normally, the answer that you will have will start with whether parce que, because, okay? Or then, pour, plus, one verb at the infinitive form, so the basic form, okay? So whether parce que, and then you just start a sentence, or then pour plus a verb at the infinitive form, okay? Let's see now some examples. First question, pourquoi es-tu ici? Pourquoi es-tu ici? Okay, ici means here. Es-tu, are you? Why are you here? Pourquoi es-tu ici? So the first answer. Parce que, so because, je suis invité, I am invited, par, by Nicolas. Because I am invited by Nicolas. Parce que je suis invité par Nicolas. Okay, so normally when you start with the parce que, so you want to express the reason why, okay? Parce que je suis invité par Nicolas. All right? And then, Other option would be pour passer la soirée. So in that case, passer should be translated like spend, okay? Pour, to spend, pour passer la soirée, the evening, avec, with, vous, you. Pour passer la soirée avec vous, to spend the evening with you. And in that case, when you will start your answer with pour, okay? So you will express what will you will do after that, okay? Pour passer la soirée avec vous, okay? And in that case, parce que you want to introduce the reason why, okay? So that's the way we will construct answers when you will ask a question with pourquoi, okay? Où est le cube? Where is the cube? Où est le cube? Okay, so let's see that together. So here, first situation. Here, okay. So this is le cube and this is le cylindre. Okay, so just to make it clear, because that's the things we'll use to introduce, well, the prepositions. Le cube est sur le cylindre. So you can see it's on. Okay, so sur le cylindre. Okay, and there is contact here. Okay, it's quite important. Second option, same thing, but it's basically under here. Le cube est sous le cylindre. Okay, le cube est sous le cylindre. Don't pronounce the final S, and then this OU combination. Vowels is pronounced ou, okay? Sous. Le cube est sous le cylindre. All right? Then, here, no contact, and that's really important, okay? Le cube est au-dessus du cylindre. So let's repeat it. Le cube est au-dessus, final S not pronounced here, au-dessus du cylindre. Okay? Then, same situation, sorry, but then the opposite, so it's here and no contact here. You can see no contact. Le cube est au-dessous du cylindre. Okay? Au-dessous, final S not pronounced, du cylindre. Le cube est au-dessous du cylindre. All right. So here, I've been putting the plural form because we've got two here. Les cubes sont à côté du cylindre. So next to, okay? Les cubes sont à côté du cylindre. Le cube est à gauche du cylindre. Okay, gauche, left, on the left of le cylindre. Le cube est à gauche du cylindre. Okay, then the next one. Droite, obviously it's right, on the right. Le cube est à droite du cylindre. Le cube est à droite du cylindre. Okay. In front of, le cube est devant le cylindre. Le cube est devant le cylindre. And now, behind, it's not possible to see it, that's the reason why. Le cube est derrière, so behind, le cylindre. Le cube est derrière le cylindre. So I've been taking away the color just to show you that it's inside, okay? So in, le cube est dans, so in, le cylindre. Le cube est dans le cylindre. Les adverbes de lieu. So really useful. And we're starting right now. So the first one that we'll see So I've been putting each time the English first and then the French version here. Okay, so here. So I won't read the English one. I will focus on the French one if that's okay with you. Ici. Ici. Okay, then là. So remember, you've got this accent, but well, you don't pronounce it. Okay, so it's là. Là. Oops. Là-bas. Là-bas. Remember, final S, not pronounced. Là-bas. Loin. Loin. So remember, when you've got this combination, O-I-N, it's loin, loin, loin. Okay? Loin. All right? So let's see them one more time. Ici. Là, là-bas, loin. Okay. Devant. Final T not pronounced. Devant. Devant. Derrière. So if you look carefully, you've got E here and then double R. So it will open the sound of this E and you should pronounce it E. Okay. Der. Derrière. Same thing here. You've got this E accent grave. E. Derrière. Okay. Don't pronounce the final E. Derrière. Okay. Final S not pronounced. Dessus. 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 Dessous. Dessous. Final S not pronounced here. Dessous. Okay, so let's repeat them. Devant, derrière, dessus, dessous. Okay? Dedans. Final S not pronounced. Dedans. Dedans. Dehors. Okay, so remember, final S not pronounced, and then this H. In French, doesn't exist phonetically, so you don't pronounce it. De or, dehors, dehors. En haut, okay. Final T not pronounced, and then this H as previously, you don't pronounce it. So this is O, en haut, en haut, en haut. En bas, final S not pronounced. En bas, en bas. Ok? Quelque part. Don't pronounce the final T. Quelque part. Quelque part. Autre part. Autre part. Autre part. Ailleurs. Look, final S not pronounced, and then you've got this y, y, y sound. Ailleurs. Okay, so sorry, I insist a little bit too much, maybe, but still, let's read it normally now. Ailleurs. Ailleurs. Okay? Autour. 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 Okay, so repeat them one more time. Quelque part. Autre part. Ailleurs, autour. Comment exprimer, sorry, comment exprimer l'obligation? So, when you must do something, well, there is a verb for that to express must, and this is falloir. Falloir, okay, falloir. And then you will have two options. The first one will be il faut, so you've got to remember that falloir is what we call verbe impersonnel, okay, because there is only one form and it's il, third person of the singular. Il faut, okay, so je, tu, nous, vous, etc., they don't exist for falloir, it's only il, okay. Il faut, and then the verb coming after will be at the infinitive. Okay, so that's the way to express to must. Okay, and then, or to have to if you want. Il faut, okay, same form, but then you will add after that un nom, a noun. Okay, so whether a verb at the infinitive form or then a noun. So we'll see few examples now. So the first scénario, as we would say in French, is falloir plus infinitif. Okay, so here, il faut respecter les règles. All right, il faut respecter, so to respect, les règles, the rules. Il faut respecter les règles. All right, and then another option, so I've been putting here and here the two parts of the negative form. Il ne faut pas fumer, fumer is to smoke, ici, here. Il ne faut pas fumer ici. Okay, so now we'll see the way it works with noun, a noun. And here, for instance, il faut, so still il faut, remember, as I said, it's only il faut, so it's a verb impersonnel, okay? Une carte d'identité. Il faut une carte d'identité. Second example here. Il faut un parapluie, umbrella, un parapluie, car, because, il pleut. It's raining. It rains. Il faut un parapluie car il pleut.